Hello, this is Emily Beach, and today we're going to talk about color. Color is an element of art that refers to the hue of something or its color. I have a color wheel in front of me right now, and what we're going to learn more about today is color relationships and color groups. In order to prepare for this lesson, all I did was I took a plastic bottle cap and I traced it 13 times on a piece of paper. Then we're going to go through each one of these color groups and I'll explain what colors are in them and how to mix the colors. For this project, the materials that I needed were my sketchbook, a pencil sharpener. You will need your primary colored pencils, red, yellow, and blue, and black and white, and a plastic bottle cap that I traced some circles, 13 circles, onto my paper. You could also use paint, watercolor, tempera paint, or acrylic paint if you wanted to do that with this exercise also. The three primary colors are red, yellow, and blue. We can use these colors to mix together and make many, many other colors. You can use these colors to make all of the colors on the color wheel. Artists can combine these colors to create an artistic composition. A lot of times when these colors are seen together, it gives you the feeling of childhood. They're nice, solid, stable colors. And again, those are red, yellow, and blue. The secondary colors are achieved when you mix two primary colors together. So when you mix yellow and blue, you get green. When you mix yellow and red, you get orange. And when you mix red and blue, you get violet. The tertiary, or sometimes called intermediate colors, are achieved when you mix a primary color with the secondary color next to it on the color wheel. Those colors are yellow-green, yellow-orange, red-orange, red-violet, blue-violet, and blue-green. When we look at the colors on the color wheel, we can get a sense for the colors that have a warmer or cooler appearance. And the warm colors, there are six of them, and the cool colors divide the color wheel in half. If you take a look at your color wheel and you draw a little line between the red and the red-violet and follow that straight across, and draw a small line between the yellow green and the green, you'll see where the color wheel is divided in half for the warm and cool colors. The warm colors are these six colors on the right side, and these cool colors are the six colors on the left side. Take a few minutes to fill in your warm colors. They are red, red orange, orange, yellow orange, yellow, and yellow green. Next, fill in your cool colors. The cool colors are green, blue, blue-violet, violet, and red-violet. Triadic colors are any three colors that are equally spaced on the color wheel. The primary colors are a triadic color set, and the secondary colors are also a triadic color set. If we take a minute to look at our color wheel, we can pick any color from the color wheel, such as this red-orange, and we could skip three, and then red-orange would also be paired with yellow-green and blue-violet. That would create a triadic color combination. Pick any triadic color combination that you like to fill in the triadic circle. When we mix colors with white, we achieve a tint. So you can pick any color from the color wheel and mix it with light white, or color it very, very lightly on the paper, and that makes a tint. The difference between tints and shades, the shades we're going to do next, if you think about shade, and if you go out into the shade on a sunny day, things get a little bit darker. So shades have black mixed in with them, but tints have white mixed in with them. Here are the shades of yellow, blue, and red with black colored over them. Monochromatic colors, look at the root of that word mono meaning one, chrome meaning color, so it is one color, but it is paired together with various tints and shades. Remember, a tint is a color mixed with white, and a shade is a color mixed with black. So we're going to pick one color. You can pick any one color. Color that in one section of your monochromatic circle. And then you will be also including several different tints, so shades of light red and several different shades of dark red. So I'm going to mix some of these with various degrees of white and some of them with various degrees of black. Complementary colors are opposite colors on the color wheel. My favorite complementary color set is red and green, and I'm going to use those as my complementary color set. But you could have a combination of yellow and violet, blue and orange, or any colors that are directly across from each other on the color wheel. Our next color group is split complementary, and that happens when you take a color on the color wheel, like red, and you go directly across from it, and its complement is green, but instead of pairing it with green, you're going to pair it with the colors on either side of green. So an example of split complementary colors would be red, blue-green, and yellow-green. Or if we wanted to do the reverse, it would be green, and then on either side of red is red-violet and red-orange. You could do that with any color on the color wheel. So this violet or blue-violet, and across from blue-violet is yellow-orange, but we would put violet with the yellow and the orange if we were doing split complementary. So pick your favorite split complementary pair, just a total of three. My next color group is neutral. When you take two complementary colors, such as red and green, and mix them together, they create a neutral tone. Neutral tones are brown, but black, white, and gray are also neutrals. Pick a few different neutral colors to color in your neutral circle. Our next color group is analogous. Analogous colors are a color group of any colors that are right next to each other on the color wheel. So you can look at your color wheel and pick out any three colors that are right next to each other. I often relate this to a group of similar close friends, and you can color those in your analogous color section. I'm going to be coloring mine yellow, yellow, orange, and orange. Thank you. So now that we've taken a little bit of time to learn about different color groups, we can start to put those into action in our future works of art and think about those when we're planning on creating new compositions and pieces of artwork. Thank you for taking a moment to watch this video, and I hope that you like it and subscribe.